Hello, everybody, and welcome to the channel. I got an exciting one for you today. So I'm going to be doing reacting to Dream Theater's new song, Night Terror. I enjoy Dream Theater. I'm not a super fan or anything, but I enjoyed their last few albums they released. View from the Top of the World was good, I thought. Distance Over Time, also pretty good album. And I even enjoyed The Astonishing. I know some fans really didn't like that album, but I kind of enjoy the kind of over the top storytelling nature of that album. Of course, I've heard other albums from them, like Metropolis Part 2, Scenes from Memory, and I really enjoyed their album. I believe it was called the album with As I Am on it. I forgot the name of it. But I enjoyed that album as well. Now, I haven't listened to all of their albums. I know the Images and Words album is considered their best album. I don't think I ever listened to the whole thing. But yeah, I enjoy me some Dream Theater. I like progressive rock. I like progressive metal and all that fun stuff. I just recently reacted to Nightwish's new album. So if you also enjoy Nightwish, go check that out. I am a orchestral composer, and so I make kind of cinematic epic style music, and so I'm just going to be reacting to this new Dream Theater song from a composer's perspective. So, without further ado, let's get into it. Dream Theater's new song, Night Terror. I'm pretty excited for this one. I heard the drummer came back, the old drummer that they used to have. Yeah, I'm excited to see what they did here. So let's hear it. Kind of got like a Halloween theme. Night Terror. Well, yeah, Night Terror, of course. Yeah, it's in the name. Cool. Drummer already having fun. This sounds like they're just jamming in their room. It sounds like they're just having fun, like being a garage band again. The double bass comes in. Look how massive his drum kit is. Yeah. Keyboardist reading his sheet music. Make sure I got all the right notes. Groovy. There he is. Sorry, his voice and his look do not match at all. I imagine this guy to be like, raw, 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 just by the way he looks. I'm sorry for that. Sacrificial Nice, this is good. Oh, and that's a keyboard. Nice. Cool. Now he's on a piano. Nice. The dominant chord. Back to one. Very catchy chorus. Gotta say, the chorus, very, very catchy. Night Terror. All right, let's keep it going. Ooh. Meter change? Or just tempo change, I'm not sure. Drummer knows all the words, so they're not just jamming like a garage band. They know the song. I'm just kidding, of course. Ooh. I like that. Yeah. The gong, the bells. Woo! Okay, this has some As I Am vibes. Nice. Very catchy. Yeah, arpeggios. Enjoy the keyboard work on this track. Groovy. Keyboard is killing it. Oh yeah. Nice. Very great composition on this entire track so far. Shouldn't have expected anything else. Like how the keys on the guitar are harmonizing here. There's like choir in the background. Or that's just a keyboard patch. Yeah. Sick. Yeah, they're back, baby! Woo! Awesome, yes! Great solo section. They just keep going. awesome, awesome solo. That was sick. Here we go. Yeah, melodic. Cool chord progression as well. Harmonic minor. Woo! Triplet in the drums. Yes! 5-7 and... That was a deceptive cadence from the 5 chord up to the 6 chord. Usually the 5-7 chord and harmonic minor will take you back to the tonic. In that case, or like the home chord, the tonic. In that case, we went up. It provides like an uplifting motion, an unexpected chord change. Listen. So 5-7 chord, and then we go up. Man, let's go. Nice. Yeah. Sick, man. These guys are back. They are back. That was really good. That was... You know, I kind of felt this way with their previous two albums. I thought Distance Over Time was better than The Astonishing, and then I thought View from the Top of the World was better than Distance Over Time. This, I think, is even better than... I don't know, maybe just because it's new, but... And like the appeal has not worn off for me yet from multiple listens, but I love it. The composition is fantastic here. Song structure is set up in a way that when the chorus comes back, it feels epic, feels magnificent to return back to the chorus. I like how James LaBrie didn't sing that much. You know, he gave the instruments time to shine. Great keyboard work. Man, the keyboard was... His fingers were smoking on fire there at the end. I am a keyboardist myself. I scooch over this way. You can see the keyboard. So, yeah, the fantastic song by the boys here. Great guitar solo as well. I really like the chorus. Very catchy. Already kind of stuck in my head. So... Yeah, looking forward to their new album. I think I'm going to react to their other new singles as they release them. So you guys can look forward to that. If you like cinematic, epic style music, please check out some of my music. It's on my YouTube channel. It would mean a lot to me if you checked it out. Please give the video a like and a subscribe if you want to see more content like this. And hey, thank you guys for making it all the way to the end. My final thoughts, Dream Theater, Night Terror, really, really cool, really good music, thought-provoking music. I didn't really go into the lyrics, but I assume they're about some bad dream, some nightmare, of course. All right, guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.
Please like and subscribe.